Welcome, colleagues. Welcome, guests. Can I see a show of hands for how many of you is this your first time in the Cellar Theater? Oh, a special welcome to you. There are quite a few people for whom this is the first time, but some the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth. I think some of us have been in this room many, many, many times, and some of us have practically lived in this room.
We invite you to sit back and enjoy and relax. Well, wait a second. We really wanted you to be in the splash zone and not sit back and relax. So hold that energy and that potential for you to come up and act with us if you are so moved or from your seats. This is a show by, for, and about teachers. New teachers, how many of you are in service, teachers have not yet taught in your own classroom? Anyone in that church? No? Okay. Lower your hands. How many of you are new teachers, new in your first year or second year? Raise your hand. Anyone here? Okay. Actors, if you would line yourself up in a continuum of number of years teaching, how many of you have taught for 5, 6 years, something like that, 8 years or less, you know? Okay, lower your hands. How many of you have taught for 10 years? Or more. More. Nice. Hands down. How many years have you taught?
24.
24 years. How many of you have taught for 24 years or more? Welcome. Experienced and new teachers.
These students have been practicing theater for social change. They each chose a social problem relating to education, and particularly their own classroom, that they were passionate about. They each researched that problem. And together, we practiced ways of enacting those problems on stage, different ways, drawing from artists from Auguste Boal to Bertolt Brecht, bread and puppet theater, etc. This theater is meant to encourage and really inspire dialogue. The dialogue is the point. So I hope that all of you will join us in the post-show discussion following the play. I would like now to introduce you to the ensemble. Their interests range from environmental and sustainability considerations in the elementary classroom, theater education through YouTube, standardized testing, and a multitude of differences in between. We are new to graduate education, and some of us have been here for years.
We've been together for a very intense, compressed amount of time. We've been leading Dr. Sahakian and myself, Misha Cahnmann-Taylor. Emily Sahakian is in theater and French, and I'm a professor of language and literacy education in the College of Ed. We've worked intensely for a short amount of summer session time from 9 in the morning till 9 or 10 or midnight or whatever have you to come here. And so we are exhausted. We are hopeful. We are uncertain. And we're here. And we're really glad you're here to welcome to Teachers Act Up. Excuse me, that's the name of my book. The name of the show is Teachers Tell All. This is a new title from the one you may have seen before, Teachers Tell All, Theater for Social Change in Our Educational Communities.
Thank you so much for spending this Friday afternoon with us. If you would please do us this favor, would you take your program and have us stand up, please? Okay. Now on your program, there's a number up at the top corner. It's on where the title is. You'll just take a moment and absorb what number program you have. And we're going to give you your first cue, okay? Your first cue is when I say 1 in 4. If your program has the number 4 on it, if you would have a seat, and if everyone else would remain standing. You got it? Your first cue? 1 in 4. Those fours will have a seat, and everybody else will stand. Ready? Here we go. Ready? You are ready.
I'm on it.
You are on it. Are you Dr. Love?
No.
Oh, okay. All right, here we go. Here we go, ready? One in four. Research shows that one in four teachers will leave the profession within their first 5 years of teaching. Take a look around. Who's missing? Whose students are not represented? One in four. Thank you.
So, probably we know that. But we also know that we're here because we love teaching. We love teaching. There's so many things to love about teaching. So what we're going to do is do a piece of theater that we have practiced together and that we invite you to participate too. I want you to be thinking about what you love about teaching. Why are you here? And troupe, think about what you love about teaching. And we're going to do a game called Emotional Symphony. But this is the teacher's Emotional Symphony. So if the ensemble will be thinking one at a time, what do you love about teaching?
Relationships. Relationships. Relationships.
Inspiring. Inspiring.
I get it! I get it! I get it!
Freeze.
Discovery. Discovery. Discovery.
Acceptance. Acceptance. Acceptance.
Freeze.
Students. Students.
Freeze.
Summer!
Someone in the splash zone want to come and add something?
I will.
I was hoping I was counting on that.
Exploration.
Again.
Exploration.
Thank you. Freeze. Anything else? One more. Dr. Tiffins, Dr. Love, you want to make someone go?
Okay, the two of you.
Oh, I can't make anybody go, so I guess I have to go. You have like no free.
Deborah, are you in the middle?
In a second.
On purpose. Yeah,
I told them that they would be volunteers.
Down here?
Yes. Let's hear it.
Go. Personality. Yeah.
I will conduct the symphony. Are you ready to repeat over and over what you said? The rule is they didn't know, but they should have known better. So, you know, professor and many years of teaching. So when I go like this, that means I want you louder. When I go like this, it means I want you to quiet down. If I go like this, it means I want you to stop. Whomever reads this hand. And then if I go like this, that means I want you to start back up again if I've stopped you. Okay, ready? Emotional Symphony of Teachers. Go.
Last year as a teacher, and I had four preparations of French, and I was a graduate student, and they asked me to coach soccer. One of my preparations was an AP French class, and the thing was, I didn't have a curriculum, I didn't have textbooks for the students, and I didn't have anyone in the building who could help me. I went to class every day, uncertain, feeling perhaps inadequate to do this job. And you know what's at the end of an AP course? An AP test. They have to get a 4 or a 5 to pass, and if they do, then it counts as a college credit and they don't have to take that class. And it translates into money saved for their parents and time saved for themselves on their educational journey. And here I am, a first year teacher, and I feel like I'm just taking a stab at it every day. And every day I heard my students talk about wanting to pass the AP test at the end of the course. And every day I so hoped that I could, but I felt like, what if I can't? Well, last week the test results came in and I just stared at the envelope. Didn't want to open it. So I waited and then I took it up to my bedroom and I just stared at the envelope. Finally, I opened it. And when I read the results, I started to cry. I just broke down. 2/3 of my AP French students made a 5. And the other 1/3 made a 4. The average score is 4.7. I can make a difference. I can help students on their journeys. Teaching French in high school, it's where I belong.
Interdisciplinary, open classroom, sustainability, empowerment,
Blumen,
teacher.
See? So we heard what we love about teaching, but there are also things that we hate about teaching. Ensemble, come up and show them. Ensemble, what do you hate about teaching?
Disconnect.
Disconnect.
Writing referrals.
Writing referrals.
Whining.
Whining.
Scripted lessons.
Scripted lessons.
about teaching you?
Readings.
Signing in and signing out like a hourly worker.
Signing in and signing out like an hourly worker.
Standardized tests.
Angry administrators.
Boredom.
Angry parents.
I don't get it.
Do you know what's really frustrating to me? I lose students. Hello, may I speak with Michael?
Yeah, he moved in with his auntie.
Hello, may I speak with Stephen?
He went back to live with his mama.
Hello, may I speak with DeAndre?
They moved to Chicago.
Beep! The number you have dialed has been designated.
Hello, honey, he ain't here.
I didn't even ask you who.
I know, but he still ain't here.
Dunkin' Donuts, how can we help you?
Where do they go?
Writing test is to find out how well you can write on a given topic in a time and given amount, in a time and given location.
I don't understand, I can't do it.
Just do your best. Ugh.
What does this word mean?
I can't tell.
But I've never seen it before.
Oh, how I want to pay that number. When results come marching
Hi, I am Kristyl Dawn. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'll edit that out. Okay. Hi, my name is Kristyl Dawn. It's my vlogger name, not my real name because I don't want you. Yeah. Kristyl Dawn. And this YouTube channel is dedicated to all things artistic. Arts education-y-ish. I got laid off from my job about 4 months, 3 days, 2 hours, and 10 seconds ago. But that was about 10 seconds, so it's 4 hours, three. It's a little later than that. Well, I was a drama school teacher, drama teacher at a middle school. I'm going to edit that out. I was a middle school drama teacher, but unfortunately our principal was feeling pressure by the superintendent, who was feeling pressure by the Board of Education to trim the budget, and so my program got trimmed. Arts are always the first to go, that and the foreign languages, I think. I should really learn one of those. Maybe I could find a YouTube channel dedicated to Spanish or something like that. Is that offensive? I'll edit that out. So, I am a middle school drama teacher, and I'm in between jobs right now because I don't have one, and I've applied for other jobs at schools and Starbucks, whatever works. But I decided that since Mr. Curtis, the technology teacher, he gets funding for his new digital media center with new video cameras, new microphones, the kids can create a digital newspaper for the school, promote football games. I decided that if they can have all of that, I'm going to use technology for my purposes. At least until I get the next job. So, you can come here to my channel, and you can click the button below and subscribe. You know, that button below the description box that you're going to see once I upload this photo, this video, this whatever. Mr. Curtis. I should call him to ask him how to do this. There's this button. I made a sign. It looks like this. The subscribe button below. So if you click here, you can come back every week and get new videos on drama. Next week I was planning to do like an overview of the stage areas, the areas of the stage, downstage, upstage. You know, a lot of people don't know that exists because they don't think that art is a craft. But it is, it's work. So this button here, the subscribe button, you can just press it.
Press it, please.
Yes! I got one!
And ma'am, you can press this button too.
I got two.
Anyone else?
Ma'am.
Thank you so much. You didn't think I'd get two, but all three.
One more, anybody? Could you please subscribe to my channel?
Yes! Thank you!
Thank you to all of the four people that subscribed to my channel. There will be more. But all jokes aside, I love the theater. I love everything about it. I love what it can do for young people, those kids in your class that you think are quiet or that maybe label stupid or slow or whatever they're labeling them now. Sometimes you can get through to a child by letting them do rather than talk, talk, talk. Some kids say through doing. They speak through doing. So, until I get the next job, you can come to my channel. I'm Kristyl Dawn. That is my vlogger name, not my real name, because I don't want you showing up at my house. But Kristyl Dawn, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. I'm gonna have to do that again.
Will you help me tie my skirt?
What is up with the hetero skirts?
They want me to wear it at school. I wanted to wear those shorts you bought me. They are so cute. But remember what happened to Dan.
What happened to Dan?
I mean, what can you do after you get laid off because you're gay?
I know. I just hate that you feel like you can't be yourself.
I mean, we just really need the money, and there's that new English position. I really, really need it.
I know. Look, try to have a good day.
I love you.
I love you.
Yes, Miss Jones, this is Miss Perkins calling from the high school.
Yes, I'm so glad you called. She just won't come to school. I don't know what to do. We bought her a tux and everything, and she's not coming back.
What are you talking about? Oh, she's not coming back? I thought she was just sick.
No, it's the prom. They told her she can't wear a tux. She can't bring a date. I mean, you're her favorite teacher. I thought you were calling about that.
She's such a great student. I really want to help. I really want to help.
Well, you're the reason she stayed in school this long. So I thought if anybody could do something, you could.
I'm so sorry. I really want to help, but we just don't do that here.
Oh, Miss Perkins!
It was really encouraging to see your name on the list for chaperones for the prom. I really hope you're going to have my back with this he-she problem. You got the chops to keep that kid out. You might have what it takes to be the department chair.
Oh, nice skirt.
I'm going to grab something I want to show you. Yeah, you can give me a call. So, I feel very lucky that I have a colleague in applied theater, and that my interests in education also have to do with performance, but not in that traditional sense, that we as teachers perform ourselves every day, and that we're faced sometimes with what may seem like insurmountable struggle and concern. And I think that I have learned in my years of being in teacher education and being a classroom teacher myself that we often don't know what to do when we're alone in that situation. And the vitality, the urgency with which we need to have a network of support in order to sustain ourselves and remain with the joy of the profession. My good colleague and student and friend Michelle Thorne talks about joy or job. You know, how we determine what field, what we're in, often determines on the kinds of support systems and experiences we can have that help us to sustain. So I have this book. This is the promo moment, Teachers Act Up. And I am excited to keep experimenting with these processes, using these kinds of techniques, and to see what new learning happens both for the students, the teachers who are the students, and also for myself as the teacher educator. And what is it that we can do? It's not like we're going to solve problems. Typical in classrooms and also in teacher ed, we're often just going to tell each other in the workroom what you should do. Oh, you might want to try this. You might want to try this. It's pretty different to come up and actually try to realize that solution. And these ideas come from a brilliant actor, director, activist named Augusto Boal from Brazil. His techniques are under his first book is called Theater of the Oppressed. And that work has moved from Brazil to around the world. For those of us who don't have perhaps the cops in the street telling us what to do or what not to do, or the dictators in public office, we often hold those cops in our heads. So we can tell each other what we do and what we don't do. How we do we or don't we stand up to that test? When and how and why are we making those choices, especially if they're things that burden us on a daily basis? So this last technique we want to share with you is called forum theater. We've taken one among many stories of recurring struggle, and we're going to perform it for you in three scenes. It has to do with a teacher faced with an administration who doesn't value their discipline or subject matter. Does that sound familiar to anyone out there? What do you do in that situation? So the scenes are broken up into three, And Splash Zone people especially, but any critical and creative thinker out there, if you can think of an idea, what could this teacher do to change that situation just in their change in their discursive self? Okay? So actors, prepare for scene one. Job application. Scene.
Hi.
Hi, Mrs. Woodbrick.
Woodhead.
Woodhead?
Woodhead. It's a crappy name. It's okay.
Have a seat.
Your resume looks great.
Yes.
For a French teacher. Summa cum laude. Summa cum laude.
Sounds great.
Is that French?
Latin-French roots has connection there.
Good. So you lived in France.
That's a great accent for a French teacher.
Okay, thank you.
And I see here that public relations was one of your undergrad majors.
It was?
Excellent. You are going to need it, honey. You are going to need it to promote this French course because, unfortunately, you know, you're going to have to fight for every day to legitimate it every single day. I mean, come on, it's not exactly literature or calculus, you understand? Well, I look forward to seeing you at the 1st of August, Mrs. Woodbridge.
Thank you, I appreciate the opportunity.
Freeze. Scene 2, job well done.
I think she knew from the door that she was not going to be valued that much.
did not make an attempt to learn her name or anything mm-hmm. about her. So that kind of set the tone mm-hmm. for how she was going to be treated throughout.
Are you willing to step up? Could you come mm-hmm. perform the
teaching?
Well, she also kind of implied, what kind of support are you going to give me? Mm-hmm. Because when she, the principal said, well, you'll need that to publicize your class, she said, why? Mm-hmm. Why do I have to do that? What are you going to do?
Mm-hmm. What is she risking by saying that?
The job,
right? I mean, you know, not to, you know, yeah, if in this economy, sometimes you need the job. So it's real. You want to set yourselves up for being in the best, most supportive position you can be in. Not always an option for everybody. I know that we have 5 minutes, and I want to introduce lightning round, okay? So that we get a sense of multiple ideas. So I'd like Jamie to take it back from the beginning, and I'd like you to think about we're going to go to the last. Excuse me, I have a better idea.
Yeah.
Both of you off stage. This is the principal. Ensemble, if you would line up. If you have another idea, please also line up. If we can use the line to go back up the stairs that way. If you don't have an idea, you can sit down or stay back. If you have an idea, we will make way and space for you, okay? So at any point, you can stand up. In ensemble, you're gonna encourage ideas and allow those people to come forward. Talk to the principal. What could you do? Give us a new idea. Anyone can come forward at any time. Scene.
Hey, Dr. Smith. How are you doing? I wanted to brag on my students. They are
page and a Twitter account, and this is catching on school-wide. Our French club is the second largest club in the school.
Freeze. Out. What'd she do that's different? Promote her program from the get-go. Anyone else?
Hi, Dr. Smith. Yeah, I want to let you know that a very unusual thing happened. At our French club meeting yesterday when we invited parents to come for like an international supper, we had 26 parents there, and they are going to approach the school PTO about a potential trip to France. This is really catching on. The parents are so excited because they see that their kids love it. Thanks for the opportunity.
See, what's different?
Community involvement.
Community involvement. There are other people, right?
Dr. Smith, what do you mean I can't teach French anymore? That's all I want to do. I love French. That's it. I guess I need to start putting in applications somewhere else.
Seeing what's different? Signed into an employer, right?
Right.
Hi, Dr. Smith, I'm sorry. I hear what you're saying. Is there any wiggle room? Is there any way we can work together? I am just so passionate about our French students. I know that I've got their support, their parental support. Is there any way that we could do a French class, you know, maybe in the morning, and then I could teach English the rest of the time? I know it's a lot of work, but I just can't let the French program go. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll be willing to do it.
Compromise, even if it means multiple more preps.
Anything else?
Sure. Dr. Smith, half of my students are committed to French class again next year. Could you just give me a couple of weeks to show you how the budget could work for this? I'm sure it can.
Seeing idea.
Students are really into it.
Say again.
The students are really into it.
Students are really into it. What else is she doing?
She's asking, or she's willing to work.
She's willing to show.
Problem solving.
I was hearing buying more time, just deferment. You know. Thank you. All right, give it up.
Oh,
you're canceling French? Seriously? Okay, all right. Oh, before I leave, hey, does your wife know that you've been sleeping with your mother?
Better on SAT scores if they've had a foreign language.
I thought that was a concern of the school. Do you no longer care about SAT scores?
Anyone have an idea and not want to get up but want to tell an actor to do it for them?
Go ahead.
The respect issue, like, demand it.
Come on, baby. Come on down. You're not shy. That's what I'm showing, my dear. You're on the side. If we had all afternoon, we would do ever many more. But for now, I want to invite the ensemble back onto the stage and to invite you to give us a round of applause. As I understand it, we get to have a conversation till 4:15. So I want to invite you, and I think Emily is going to facilitate this part, and she'll tell us where to sit and be and how to be.
Ensemble, if you want to grab a chair or your block and just take a seat on stage and kind of up here so that we can be closer to our audience with whom we're having a conversation. First, I just want to ask, in these scenes that you saw, a lot of them were symbolic and a variety of scenes. Did anybody see a problem or a situation that you recognized, or perhaps that you related to? Tell us what it was.
Several of them were similar to my teaching experience. Statistics, as far as thinking about the teachers that I started with and the teachers that left, and I guess in a way I left to come to the academy. So thinking about the things that concern me as a teacher, the things that cause me to, you know, not have that passion. And then even the artistic ability about the YouTubing and cutting arts and just really focusing on whatever subjects are being tested.
Michelle and Kristyl want to speak a little bit about your process in response to this noticing of your scenes, a little bit about how you chose the topics and what research you did.
I took an online course this summer, my first one ever, and fell in love with it because I thought, okay, I've always thought, well, how can you translate theater to, you know,
to the internet. I mean, how can you make something so live work, you know, in the digital world? And I think it's possible. And so my thinking was, after looking at the research and looking at, you know, the statistics that show that, you know, because of our current recession, a lot of the arts programs have been sort of cut or cut back, you know, the funding for it, which is problematic. But I figured, well, from that class, I thought, well, there's going to be no choice other than to find other ways to teach things like drama and dance. And even though video is quite inadequate, that may be what we're going to have to do. Find a way to take this technology that all of this money has been put into and use it for our own purposes.
And Michelle did the research on teacher retention and the 1 in 4.
And that's actually a conservative, you know, several bits of research. Some of those maybe is half. And then that doesn't, and then it's the different points in the career. The thing that I found so disheartening was it was in the first 5 years. And it's, and the other interesting piece of it to me was that the people, most of us and the people researched, didn't go into teaching thinking they were going to make a lot of money. So it wasn't the compensation or lack thereof. They knew they could make more of the professions, but they chose teaching. But these things happen and just suck the joy right out of it, and they burn out and go somewhere else.
Thank you. It's helpful for us to know what you see and what you recognize. Yeah.
I like the scene about speaking Spanish in class, because we've been talking a lot in Dr. Love's class about funds of knowledge and what these kids bring into the classroom. You know, and it was obviously the two girls that were down there playing, that was a high fund of knowledge for them, and mm-hmm. everyone in the class could have benefited from that, but they got shut down. So.
Right.
And I really resonated with the same thing, because I had an opportunity to work with the Hispanic community with some mothers and daughters, and they've been telling me about their experience at the school, and they were telling me how, as workers, they are so invisible because they get to work 12 to 15 hours every day, 24/7, year-round, in the constructions, and nobody sees them as workers. But when it comes to school, when there is anything cultural that they want to display, like their language, not only teachers, but even their peers come to them and tell them that it's in America that they shouldn't speak Spanish here. So I think that's something that we need to be really, we need to keep an eye not only as teachers about what we do, but at the same time, you know, what our students, what kind of relationships they have, because Georgia right now has very high number of Hispanic students, and it continues to increase since 1999, which the statistics show that the increase was 700%. So.
I wanted to jump in again, sorry, about the march. I taught in Atlanta, and we actually did that, like things like that, to celebrate the testing scores, and ran off the whole Georgia dorm and sent all the schools there. And there was a year that they had a Mardi Gras theme, and they literally had the 100%, like, wow. The people that made the top scores and walked around with, and they had, like, it literally happened. So that one really took me back to, you know, that seems so laughable, but that actually happened.
There was someone in the back.
Yeah, what did others think about that one? Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, where did they go with the phone calls? Really hit home for me, because I teach at a school that's the home school for the homeless population in Clark County. And so kids, when they don't have a home school, they're brought to our school, and then when they get a home, it's typically not in our district, so then they leave halfway through the year. So it's good that they got a home, but then we've made this, you know, connection with these students, and they leave, and the disconnected phones, and moving around, and a lot of people want to be in districts, so they say they live with somebody that they don't, and there's a lot of that going on, and a lot of it is in a parent's mind for the benefit of their child. But from a teacher's standpoint, sometimes you get the where you can't call home, and you don't know where your students even go in the afternoon.
So you relate to that frustration that Cindy expressed. Yeah.
I really related to the test score a lot, because in the district where I teach, they send out a letter twice a year to every student, saying that they only have to pass math and reading to get to the next grade level. So all the students and their parents take that to mean science and social studies just don't count. And the thing that killed me was, like, you had the dollar bills on the hats and the bongo and everything, and all the money follows the good scores. And the subjects that need it the most don't get any funding. And then they're like, your scores suck. We're like, no, sorry, I'm broke.
I think one thing I kind of took in a different angle, but when y'all did the different feelings that you felt, like inspirational, and everyone kind of did their own thing and paused it, I was thinking if you were to be teaching a story, then you could have what the main character feels at different points in the story, and you could have the kids kind of create like a drama act. Or in math, like I taught geometry, so you could have different students doing different angles for a 90 degree and just kind of using that sense of art in different content areas as like a strategy for like full whole-based learning.
Well, we're thrilled to hear you say that, because that is one of the things that we have been doing in our class. And we've been able to practice different games and always talk about how we would adapt them to our own classrooms. And yesterday, the students each presented a game the way that they would in their own class. And there are so many possibilities. And we're so happy that our performance communicated that to you. I mean, in addition to these issues, we're so happy that you're relating to them. I'm interested in asking about this testing. You know, it really happens is one interpretation. And so for you, the music was about the money. Is that what you're saying? Do we have other interpretations of what was going on in this testing scene?
Well, I guess for me, we just had a class about this maybe an hour ago, about this whole neoliberal agenda with the testing. Mm-hmm. So you have the testing companies' names under like the money, mm-hmm. and how that's playing out in our educational system and what that means for us as educators. We are part of this system.
Mm-hmm. And then we also had kids that were labeled because mm-hmm. they're in a way parading what their label was, and even the student that didn't meet, her label was out there for everybody to see.
You can see the effect it had on each kid as you handed it to them. Some kids were really excited, and other kids were kind of like, oh gosh, everybody else saw that.
Mm-hmm. It's identity changing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so I think of, like, on my grade level this past spring, of how much time most of the teachers spend on bubble practice and ABCD choices and all of that. And I can say, my kids did that maybe 15 minutes and we're done. You know, third grade, you should be able to color a circle. And if you can't, why am I going to spend 2 months before a test teaching you how to fill in a circle?
I think that goes to the eraser marks and all the scandals going on with cheating and how they have, they want kids really not to change their answer unless they absolutely have to.
I would love to discuss longer. I think that all of these actors would be eager to share their research and their process of making the scene with you, and it's wonderful to hear this feedback from you, but I want to be mindful of time because I know that our time is over at 4:15. So I just want to ask a last question about the value of spending your time with us here this afternoon. I loved how you connected one of our scenes to a reading in class. So I want to pose the question, is it worth it to see and hear an experience at the theater? And how is it different from learning through class? Learning through experience, which is also a performative experience. Yes.
I'm actually an undergraduate student, and I really appreciated seeing the love and hate scenes. I think that too often in our undergraduate program, we sometimes only see the love, and then you get into the school and you're discouraged. And at the same time, when we're going through our practicums, you hear too many teachers only talking about the hate. And for me, I really appreciated seeing both sides because it's a reminder that there are going to be things that you hate, but passion and seeing that I get it, those things that you love, if you can take those and use them to appreciate teaching more, then the love overcomes the hate. And just sometimes just being aware that there is the hate, but there is the love, is inspiring to continue the path of wanting to be a teacher.
I think we were very aware of that in each of our scenes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think this is an interesting practice for those who are not in the classroom, but are directly involved with affecting us in the classroom, like administrators, county level operators, things like that, who have a direct power over what goes on, for them to feel what it's like to be a teacher. And then either they're very removed from it because they've moved on 10 years, or they've never been in the classroom, so they have no idea. So at least to give them that opportunity to see and I think it's somehow participate, I think would be very useful.
I'm wondering how this could affect like a faculty meeting. You know, doing this in a faculty meeting, how that would change the vibe and the way whoever's running it would present it. I just really, instead of listing the problems, talking about or acting out the solutions, or even like after you're done with an evaluation, instead of just reading off the list, talking and performing ways to fix or apply what's been done.
Have you hold that comment because we want to respect the time and we'll stay for more conversation, but I just want to say that our hope, deep hope, is that the folks who've spent this time with us will feel confident to be leaders of such activity. We feel lucky that the Athens Banner Herald is here and maybe we'll cover it for a wider audience for us. We feel lucky that maybe we'll have some video thanks to Ron that will be linked to this College of Education YouTube channel so that we can all revisit this together with stakeholders beyond this performance. And we feel hopeful that maybe some of you will want to work with us next summer if we get to do this again. So please let that feeling be known.
And we feel lucky to have shared this moment with you. Thank you for your listening and your engagement with the performance.
Thank you very much.